Hi there, and welcome to this video on Transactions zipForm Edition. Today, we'll be looking at the different user roles in a brokerage account and how to create them. Let's go ahead and get started. Let's first look at the four different roles within a brokerage account that you can create. Agents will make up the bulk of the users on a brokerage account. These are the real estate agents creating and managing their transactions as they go about their day-to-day tasks. Transaction coordinators can assist agents with the admin related to creating and managing transactions. They will also have access to all agent accounts in order to assist them. An officer team admin will have administrator rights but limited to a specific officer team. They won't have admin access to the entire brokerage account. They're able to create and manage accounts along with approving documents and transactions. However, as previously mentioned, this is limited to just their team or office. A broker admin has full administrator rights across all accounts in a brokerage account. They're able to create and manage accounts along with approving documents and transactions. Now let's go through the process of creating a new user. We're going to do this from a broker admin account for demonstration purposes. We'll start by clicking on the Admin tab in the navigation bar, then going down to Users. In the Users page, you'll see the list of all the users on your brokerage account. You can tell them apart by using this guide near the top. Broker admins are red, office team admins are yellow, agents are blue, and transaction coordinators are orange. Let's create a new user by clicking on New in the top left-hand corner. There are five sections you'll need to complete in order to create a new user. Any area with a red asterisk next to it is a mandatory field and must be completed in order to continue. This first section is general information. Here you choose what role you want the user to be. In this case, we're going to go with agent. You can also upload a photo for their profile. Once you've filled in all the required fields, you can click Next. The second section is office information. This is where you can choose which office you want the user to belong to. This is very important for any office admin, as their access is office specific. By default, the user will also be added to the corporate office. If you've purchased Lone Wolf Link for Transaction zipForm Edition, ensure that you have selected an office location in addition to corporate. Once you've chosen any additional offices you want the user to belong to, click Next. The third section is Libraries. This is where you can choose which form libraries you want the user to have access to. Note that transaction coordinators automatically get access to the form libraries on the account of the user they're assisting. So when you create a transaction coordinator, this step will disappear from the process. Once you've chosen the respective libraries, click Next to continue. The fourth section is Products. This is where you can choose what products the user will have access to, such as MLS Connect, Mobile Edition, Digital Link, and many others. Once you've chosen the respective products, click Next to continue. The last section is Permissions. This is where you can customize the permission settings for the user. For example, if we were creating this profile for a very new agent and wanted to restrict them, we could untick Can Create Personal Templates so that we as a broker admin can determine what templates they can use. You can change permissions for all four user types. Once you're ready to finish and create the user profile, click Save. You can always change any settings on a user's profile by simply clicking on it. From this menu, you can edit a user's profile from what was initially set up. Edit User Info lets you edit their basic information, including changing their role, for example, from an agent to a transaction coordinator. Office Info allows you to view and change their office settings. Manage Products allows you to view and change what products they have access to. User Permissions allows you to change their permission setup. Other important areas include Reset Password, Lock Account, and Delete Account. Note that locking an account does not free up a seat or assign products in libraries. Only deleting a user profile will free up a seat. If you do delete a user profile, you also delete any transactions within it, so it may be worth moving them out prior to deleting a profile. That sums up this video on the different user roles in a brokerage account for Transactions ZipForm Edition. For more detailed information, we invite you to check out one of our webinars by clicking on the link in the description.